Hi, I'm Inachi Sasuke. I don't use Crunchyroll. I'm not being sponsored by Crunchyroll. But they have great anime, and they're really nice. Look, they say, we hope you're having a nice day. Please enjoy as much anime as you like, and look at all the anime they have. They've got 472 videos of Naruto, a whole lot of One Piece. I'm not even sure what ReZero is. They've got Food Wars. And you can even join their premium and try it for free. They've got a store. Let's see what's in the store. You can get t-shirts and accessories, books, cosplay, figures. All these things are right there at Crunchyroll for you to check out at your leisure. So come on down to Crunchyroll to watch anime, buy anime figurines, and it has absolutely nothing to do with Homestuck. Have a nice day, now on with the actual program. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Okay. Previously on Homestuck, we got psyched out. Nobody got psyched out. It's been, like, some time now, and a lot of people already know what happens with this dude. Look at them sunglasses and that Snoop Dogg. Look at that Snoop Dogg dog. But, first things first, the last time I was recording these things, for whatever reason, I had the microphone sideways, because I thought, hey, if it's sideways, it'll catch my talkity talk better, right? Wrong. It did not catch my talkity talk better, it in fact was shit. So, speaking of shit, time to read about Dave Strider. Nyeh! Why is this still visible? It's not supposed to be. Anyway. There's this really cool dude, okay? He's standing around being all chill like cool dudes are known to do some- Wait, I forgot to take off my visibilities. Like cool dudes are known to do sometimes. A cool dude like this probably has a really cool name, but he probably wouldn't just tell you what it was if you asked. He'd be way too busy for that, busy being totally sweet. But you could always try to guess his name, and if you were right, he might nod ever so slightly. That's a cool dude's way of letting you know there might just be hope for you yet. Let's enter that name. Oh, there it goes. Insufferable? This guy doesn't have time for this sort of bullshit. Try again. The name is Dave Strider. Shing! Now let's look around his house like creepers. Your name is Dave. It is an unseasonably warm April day. What a coincidence! It's hot as balls this day in August! Oh man, we get along. Me and Dave? No, we don't. My sunglasses aren't even in here. And they have never been on Ben Stiller's face. Your bedroom window is open to let in some air, and your fan is cranked. Arguably even more cranked would be your fly beats, which brings us to your variety of interests. A cool dude like you is sure to have plenty. You have a penchant for spinning out unbelievably ill jams with your turntables and mixing gear. You like to rave about bands no one's ever heard of but you, you fucking hipster. You collect weird dead things preserved in various ways. You are an amateur photographer and operate your own makeshift darkroom. You maintain a number of ironically humorous blogs, websites, and social networking profiles. And if the inspiration strikes, you won't hesitate to drop some fat rhymes on a mofo and represent. What will you do? Oh my god. Okay. Quickly retrieve arms from cinder blocks. That's not where arms would be. Nah. Get the damn bait and save your friend's life! This notion strikes you as nonsensical. You can't imagine how a video game could save someone's life, and in any case, you're quite sure no one you know is in any danger. Anyway, these are your copies of the beta you received in the mail recently. You've labeled them with your name in bold red print to distinguish him from your bro's copies, who labeled his in kind. Neither of you really gives a shit about this game or has any intention of playing it, but you'll be damned if you'll let that get in the way of your campaign of one-upmanship. Dave, bleat like a goat and piss on your turntable. You would never consider allowing any fluid even remotely resembling urine to touch your beloved turntables. That would risk breaking them in a world without the gift of your godly science just doesn't sound like a place you want any part of. While you're at it, you might as well wipe out human civilization with a meteor or something ridiculous like that, which will probably never happen. That sort of thing only happens in stupid idiot movies for stupid idiots. You will, however, contemplate bleeding like a goat for ironically humorous purposes at a later date. Does he ever do that? I don't know if he ever does that. Examine the closet! This is your closet. This is where you keep a lot of your crap. Like that box and that bottle of... What is that? Is that... Let's check the blue box. Dun-dun. Ben Stiller! This is the package that your friend John Egbert sent you for your 13th birthday a little while ago. It now contains nothing except a note and a certificate of authenticity, vouching for the genuine Hollywood memorabilia which the box originally contained, and which you are now wearing to be ironic, but also to be incredibly cool in a way somehow intangibly related to the ironic nature of this accessory. You find it sort of exasperating to explain these subtleties to people. The box also included a signed photo of Ben Stiller, which now proudly hangs above your closet. Proudly and ironically. That's important. Take the box! You capture log the box through your hash map fetch modus. Your modus's current hash function resolves the index by valuing each consonant at 2, and each vowel, I haven't said that in a while, at 1. The total is divided by your number of cards, and the remainder is the index. Box 2125. 5%, 10-5. Okay. The box is capture logged in card 5. Let's examine that bottle in your closet. Oh, hell yes. It's an unopened container of apple juice. You thought you were all out. It's like fucking Christmas up in here. This is so great. You've got to tell John about this immediately. He'll be so excited. Let's take that shit.
Appleface!
You capture log the juice in the card 7211211107. Access Pastor Chum and Pastor John. In addition to letting your buddy know about this outstanding juice windfall, you figure you'll wish him a happy birthday while you're at it. In your own cool, sort of roundabout way, of course. Good thing you looked at that box he sent you or you might have forgotten. You also might as well ask him about that beta. The kid's been harboring about it for weeks. It would be cool if it came on his birthday. He'd be one happy camper. We seem to have gone back in time. Hey, look, complete bullshit. Just like the ill beats. Beep. Turn to Godhead to began pestering ectobiologist Abe at 1813. Hey, so we've already been through this. Go online and view sites indicative of your interest. You open the Hephaestus web browser and direct it to your ironically maintained blog where you post monthly satirical reviews of GamePro magazine. Your latest post is a review of the March issue. Ah jeez, let's check out that review. GamePro! Frito-Lay Grand Snack, fuck yeah! Spicy, was it great chili? I don't even know what most of this shit is. I do see some Pringles though. What is that? Right, Rider Crazers? Pizza Cravers? Did these things exist? What the fuck? Anyway, you've been meaning to write a review for the latest issue too, but you've been sort of dodging it, dogging it. Something about the game they're reviewing just doesn't strike you as ripe for satirical purposes. In a new tab, you open another one of your sites, a webcomic ironically maintained through a satirical cipher vaguely similar to that of your blog. It's called Sweet Bro and Hella Jeff. You have legions of devoted fans, most of whom are totally convinced of your creative persona's sincerity, which is just how you like it. Let's check that shit out, too. Good God. I can't wait to be a useless piece of shit all day and play these games. Fuck falling down all these stairs. I warned you about the stairs, bro. I told you, dog. It keeps happening. I told you, man. I told you about the stairs. Oh, God. This website's hurting my soul. I can't tell how many of these things are actual advertisements. A bunch of other comics, comomics. Oh man. How far? Tony Hawk, what happened to you, man? Let's see. I wonder what the most recent comic is. newest comic. What the fuck? What is this? Okay, so let's get the hell out of here. Okay. Check the latest page of the Midnight Crew. You figure as long as you're chilling at your computer, you might as well see how the new MISPA story is going. You haven't looked at it in a while? Midnight Crew. Oh, we're going to do this? Alright. You are members of a sinister gang called the Midnight Crew. Your nefarious plots are serpentine in complexity. Your schemes convoluted. You are planning a heist in your underground hideout. What will you do? Use Occam's razor on plans and schemes. Is he gonna do it? Is he gonna do it? Or is that okay? Spade Slick uses Occam's razor to carve a circular hole into the heist plans, freeing it from the knife. You wonder what moron would jam the knife so hard into the table in the first place. Climb ladder and exit hideout. Implement nefarious plots. Oh, he's actually doing it. You push against the manhole cover, but it seems some unbelievable jackass has parked your getaway van on top of it. A familiar feeling stirs. That feeling is overwhelming. Soul-blackening rage! It's the sort of rage that'll make a man feel totally justified in sporting an unnecessary, elaborate assortment of fancy blades. Skip ahead 100 pages or so! You don't remember where you last left off, so you jump way ahead. You always forget to save your place in the story, right? So do I! It looks like tempers have become short in this pressure cooker already. You speculate that the tipping point may have been an ill-advised motion for a game of 52 Pika. Save your place and read it later. Hey, a blender! Through the wall. Even though the adventure began recently, it's already over 3,000 pages long. You just don't have time for this bullshit. You'll catch up later. Okay. Besides, it looks like someone's pestering you. You're pretty sure you know who it is. Let's answer your chum! Fuck it. In some cultures, the persistent refusal of a lady's invitation to play a game with her would be a sign of wanton disrespect. Either that, or flagrant homosexuality. What? Oh, no. Look, I'm busy, okay? I've got a lot of shit on my plate. I'm sort of a big deal, okay? I know, sometimes I wonder how you ever allowed to pay for meals in restaurants. It must be hard to keep a low profile when you're always overhearing odd voices whisper, "It's that guy who has a blog!" Seriously, dudes be worshipping me left and right. I can't hardly walk down the street without stepping over torsos of the prostate. See now, do prostates have torsos? Because the torsos... Anyway. Navigating the urban landscape, I'm pretty sure, is difficult enough without an obstacle course of differential flesh and skyward acids. Perhaps adapting the art of parkour to your unique environment would help? Yeah, I mean, damn, like, there's this scruffy little shit at my feet, an orphan or something, I don't know, flesh on the pavement. I'm like, dude, you listening for a stampede or buffalo or something? He braves a look at me and then gives my shoe a little kiss and scurries the fuck off. Heavy is the crown. Yeah, not kicking Oliver Twist in the fucking face every day is my gift to the world, I guess. Breathtaking magnanimity. Whatever. Fuck. Okay, let me say it in spaces. Magnanimity. Alright. Among other things, I just give and fucking give. Indeed, nary a jewel tumbles from your wishbox of daily exploits, which I imagine does not sparkle. Oh, for fuck's sake! You're just lobbying for me to play that dumb game. Baseless accusation! Look, I'm telling you, Egbert is all about that game. He'll play it with you and probably be tickled retarded about it. I know this very well. I cannot hasten his mail's delivery, however. Yeah, I'll hassle him some more about it. And look, how about this? If you ever find yourself in the position where your life depends on me playing that piece of shit game, then I'll play it. Will that make you happy? More than you know. It perfectly mollifies my grief over the demise of Chivalry. Oh, man. Rose, what's with these words I can't pronounce for shit? I never use these words. Chivalry. Alright, cool. John, what are you doing? Stop doing nothing! Meanwhile, in the present, in a place where the present may be a concept of dubious merit, John is spacing out. But a vague and forceful thought jolts him to attention. Or maybe it's that bumping sound coming from the other side of the door. What is that? Bum-bum. 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 Okay. Question mark? A thick, unpleasant, fluid pools from beneath the door. Troubling? Investigate this. Wait a minute. There is a trail of this fluid in the hall leading to your room. Dave, play some hauntingly sick beats. You've had enough of the computer for a while. It feels like you've been messing around on it all week. It's time to get your jam on. You pull up your trusty Ikei McQuick 1000 sampler and prepare to get sick nasty, yo. Let's give it a listen. Aw, shit. We get to play the sick nasty beats. It's probably just gonna be sick and nasty though, not at the same time. Okay. Storing shit, but that was alright. Take a sip of the apple juice despite what John said. Those beets were so fresh they belong in the produce aisle. It's what you're talking about. Soccer moms be thumping that shit for ripeness like melons, know what I'm saying? After beets that fresh, it would be a crime not to reward yourself with a celebratory swig! 2-1-2-10-7. Dun dun. Dun dun. Da! Da! You can't do it! John's got you all twisted up inside now. All you can think about is Mandel's gross monster piss. Damn you, Egbert! Skinner! Okay, so. You recapture log the juice. Allocate sword to strike specimens. I said. Okay. You alright, website? Yeah, you alright? Okay, it's loading. Your strike specimen is already allocated with the Bladekin Abstratus. There's no need to allocate it. You can wield your sweet ninja sword as a weapon once it is in your strike deck, but you will have to capture log it first before moving it there. Capture log that bitch! The ninja sword 21221 plus 2-1-2-2=17-10-7 occupies the same card as your juice 2-1-1-2-1-7-10-7, expelling the juice from your Silodex. It splashes all over your turntables and your copies of the beta. Ugh! Get a towel or something, Jesus. You head out to get a towel from the bathroom across the hall. You glance at one of the many radical puppets in your bro's collection and nod in approval. Is there anything not awesome about your bro? Nah, you think not. You enter the bathroom. There's a damp towel on the floor you can probably use for this crisis. You stop to pay a little respect to one of your bro's boys up there. Hey, little man, how's it hanging? By the arms and legs from the look of it. Capture log, damp towel. You take the damp towel 2-1-2-2 plus 2-1-2-1-2=15-10-5, expelling the box 2-1-2-5-10-5. Search the bathroom for something slightly less damp. Nah, you just decided to wring this towel out into the toilet to make it less damp. Now it's just a towel 2-1-2-1-2-8-10-8. Take towel. You take the towel and grab the box again while you're at it. Now let's clean up that juice! Okay. You clean 2-2-1-1-2-8 up the juice with the towel and hang the damp beta envelopes on your line to dry off. Should I say envelopes or envelopes? Because, I don't know, I say envelopes. Wind! Hipster! Fan! In the breeze of the fan, the betas jostle near the open window. This arrangement's a little disconcerting. If they fell out, it sure would be a stupid way to lose them. Turn off the fan. Click. The crisis is easily averted. You can't imagine it will ever resurface later in any way, shape, or form. That beta is as good as yours forever. You should probably go past your Egbert again. You wonder if he found the beta yet. You also might chat about your respective Silodexes and Fetch Modi if the topic happens to come up. You wonder if he's anywhere near as smooth with his Silodex as you are. Probably not. It's probably not even humanly possible. Bird! Suddenly, a rambunctious crow flies in the open window and snatches the beta pocket to make a nest with. Or maybe just for the sake of being a brainless, feathery asshole. You yell at the bird. You yell at the bird. Stop! 22127. Sword flies across the room. You accidentally launch your ninja sword. Everything goes flying out the window, dead bird and all. Shot through the heart! Okay. No one can ever know about this. Look out the window, though. Yeah, you can kiss all that stuff goodbye. You feel sorry for the bird, but at least you never planned on using that beta ever. What the fuck? Anyway, now that that bird bit of ugliness is behind you, you guess you can look forward to several more hours of messing around in your room and— Whoa, wait, what? Wizard man! Rose. Creepy wizard paintings. Strange wizard man. On the one hand, I want to stop